Name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Father, we thank you very much for this chance to come and to meet together and to share the five love languages. Lord, you are the author of love because God is love. Thank you for making yourself present to us today and help us to learn and to consider mostly how you are central in our life and that all the love that we share with others comes from you. We thank you for your love, for your blessings. Thank you for those that traveled from a distance to get here. Appreciate that. And for all those that live in a relationship of love, we ask you to guide them and to encourage them in all things. In all this we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And be with Margaret during the presentation.
I see that some of you are new this week. Basically, last week we went over the first three chapters from this book, The Five Love Languages, and just talked about love and what is the definition of love. This week, I'm going to explain the five love languages, not in depth, but just explain it. And then from there, we're going to take a little quiz. I'll hand that out for you. It's only between you, and it tells you what your love language is. So each one of you will do one. If you have a spouse, that's not here, you can take one home for her as well. And then next week, we'll go over ways to meet your partner's love language in more detail. So we'll give a lot of different examples of how you can meet their love language. So this is just going to be a brief overview today of the five love languages. So last week, we talked about the five, which is words of affirmation, quality time, receiving gifts, acts of service, and physical touch. Encouragement requires empathy and seeing the world from your spouse's perspective. We must first learn what is important to our spouse. Now, last week, I asked couples to look at each other and guess what their love language is and guess what your love language is. So I'm going to go through real quick and before we go down here, and you tell me what you think your love language is and what your spouse's love language is with backing up, that one right there. Okay, Jedney, what do you think yours is? And what do you think hers is? What do you think yours is? Okay, what do you think yours is?
They were here last week.
I know, but they're looking, we're just guessing. We're just guessing right now. Which one do you think you really need a lot of? Which one?
Words of affirmation he needs.
Okay. What do you think you need?
Quality time.
Okay. And you think what? And what do you think yours is?
Acts of service.
Okay. And what do you think hers is? Dave, what do you think hers is?
Which one?
No, which five?
What do I need?
What do you think she needs? This is a good quiz.
Yeah.
Okay, well, you'll find out in a little bit because we're going to take the quiz. What do you think yours is?
Quality time.
What do you think your wife's is?
My wife's probably acts of service.
Okay, so we'll see when you guys take the quiz to see if you're meeting the right love language. Okay? There's Rose. Okay, we're going to watch a short little video. Now, if this is annoying to you, the video, we have five little short ones on each love language. And so if it's real annoying, then we won't watch the other four, okay? Go ahead. That was physical touch. Gifts. words of affirmation. So Mark Twain said, I can live for 2 months on a good compliment. Reckless words pierce like a sword, but the tongue of the wise brings healing. That's from Proverbs. A gentle answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. That's also from Proverbs. And you can see the little dog nagging the other dog. You know, how many of you nag? If you nag and your partner or your spouse is words of affirmation, it's not going to work too well, okay? Verbal compliments are far greater motivators than nagging words. Okay, the next one is quality time. Those of you who came in, we'll go back to you in a minute. We're going to find out what your love language, what you think it is before we take the quiz. Okay, the next one is quality time. So how annoying was the last little video, okay? Okay. So that was physical touch, gifts, quality time. So for you, those of you who were not here last week, just a quick background. Everybody has a gas tank for love. And if you have a quality, you have a love language, and your spouse doesn't meet your love language, the gas tank is going to stay empty, okay? If, for example, Jerry's is words of affirmation, so if I'm chewing him out all the time, his tank is going to be down here, okay? So when we have problems, then you have no reserve, okay? But if I give him lots of compliments and talk to him, you know, tell him thank you for all the different things, his will be up here, so when you have problems, and every couple has problems, then it will just go down just a little bit. Now, let's say I give him gifts. That's really not one of his, so that's not going to fill his love tank. It'll be nice, but it's not going to fill his love tank, okay? So that's just for those who were not here last week.
Margaret, I would just say that the one reason why words of affirmation are important to me is because I want to know that I'm doing things that please you.
Right. But each... Exactly, you got to get my love language. Emphasis is not on what you're doing, but on why you're doing it. Together is focused attention, not proximity. That's what we were talking about earlier. You could sit together and watch a movie, but that's not really quality time unless you're talking and discussing the movie. Quality time means you're spending time communicating. Movies aren't really a good example of quality time. Giving someone your undivided attention. Sharing an activity in which we are giving our full attention to the other person. Quality conversation, focusing on what we are hearing, listening sympathetically. The next one is receiving gifts. See if you can pick out what the different five love languages. Acts of service. So none of the love languages are better than the other. Sometimes we think, oh, okay, well, that person who wants gifts is a little shallow. That's not true. That's just, I mean, it can be a flower that you give the person. It does not mean that you're shallow or anything else. And many times people think that their love language is better than somebody else's. So it's important to look at it as equal. That's just who you are. So gifts are visible symbols of love that have emotional value. And that's the important part, like one rose giving to somebody. It's just a rose, but it's the emotion behind it. All good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no alteration or shadow caused by change. It doesn't have to be expensive. It has nothing to do with the monetary value and everything to do with love. What's something little that you can give somebody? It doesn't have to cost a lot. Anybody have ideas? Next week we're going to have lots of ideas, but anybody have an idea? A smile. That's a good gift.
Hug.
What?
A hug.
A hug? Okay. Now remember, that could also be physical touch. So, okay. This was our simple gift. A dog, but then also she has simple gifts. So, okay, acts of service. Thank you, Rose. Some parents can identify with this. You probably can identify this weekend. Physical touch, she didn't want it. That's acts of service. Okay. You, my brothers, were called to be free, but do not use your freedom to indulge the sinful nature. Rather, serve one another in love. The entire law is summed up in a single command, love your neighbor as yourself. I would say many of you here do a lot of service. Actually, I can see a lot of you that do. You call me teacher and Lord, and rightly so, for that is what I am. Now that I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also should wash one another's feet. I have set you an example that you should do as I have done for you. doing things you know your spouse would like you to do. In the book, they talk about this guy is out there washing the car and cleaning the car for his wife, and she goes and complains to the counselor and says, you know, it was a beautiful day, but I wanted him to come in and paint. I've been asking him to paint for quite some time. So he thought he was doing what she wanted, but really, he wasn't listening to her. So it requires thought, planning, time, effort, energy, and a positive spirit. Even dogs can be acts of service. Okay. The last one is physical touch. Gift. By the way, if you have children or grandchildren, it'd be interesting to find out what theirs is to make sure you're meeting their needs. Jesus recognized the importance of showing love through physical touch. Filled with compassion, Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. We have anointing of the sick where they touch. Many of our sacraments, confirmation, there's touching. Of course, there's physical touch there with grandkids. There's Jerry. He's copying Cameron. And love is a choice you make every day. Okay. Turn it on. I'm now going to hand out the quiz, but before I do that, we missed some people in the back there in the front. Now that you've seen the video, what do you think your love language is?
Touch.
Okay, what do you think yours is?
Can you have two? Or?
Yes, you can. No, actually, we'll talk about that if they're real close when you take the quiz.
The acts of service and the affirmation.
Would you think that that's what hers was? Make sure, Jerry, you give the couples ones. That's singles, I think.
This one says couples.
Okay. And there should be two pages. All right, let's go over here. Wendy, what do you think yours is? You think yours, if somebody gives to you, it makes you feel loved.
No, no, the one I give to others is acts of service.
Right, but what...
And
last week I talked about that. Many times if we give to someone else, that's what ours is, okay? And we don't think about that. What do you think Brian's is?
Oh my goodness, I think he has more than one.
What would be his top one? You can take a quiz home for him.
What would I think is probably, it's a combination, but it's also acts of service, doing little things.
Okay, and you'll see tonight when you do your little quiz. All right, what do you think?
Mine, I think, is physical touch.
Okay.
And quality time, but I'm going to discuss quality time.
Okay, we will in just a second. Okay. What do you think?
Physical touch and quality.
Oh, okay, that's this couple right here. They have the same ones. We'll see. Okay, and back there, the person that Jerry's handing a paper to.
Your turn.
What do you think yours is? Okay. All right. Well, now you have the quiz, if you'll take that. Now you're going to go, this isn't fair. They only give me two choices on each question. He's redone this several times, Gary Chapman has, to make it more accurate. So make sure, you know, just occasionally, it will throw the score off, though, if you circle both. Try not to circle both. Did he give you one yet?
No.
or he's moving his... Next week, we'll go through if there's people who have concerns about what they have down versus what they thought they were. We'll also go through, Jedney brought up that, or I guess it was Francesca brought up about, well, I like to be, what was it, hugged or kiss? Kiss better, or hug better than kiss. That's what we call a dialect of the primary love language, okay? And you have to learn the dialect as well as the primary love language of your partner, okay? We'll go ahead and start from the back, and if you'll tell us if what you thought you were matches what you showed up on the quiz. What was your primary love language? We'll start with you way back in the back.
I said acts of service.
Is that what you said before?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right.
Mine is physical touch.
Okay.
Mine is physical touch.
Okay. Did you realize that before?
No.
Okay. All right. Wendy, we'll go up this row and then back down. Okay. That's actually the two of mine. No, mine's quality time and physical touch. Okay, go ahead.
I have physical touch and quality time.
Okay.
Quality time and words of affirmation.
Oh, different than you thought. Okay.
No, you have the same from that.
Okay, but you have a different
order.
Okay. But yours is quality time and his is affirmation now.
Yeah.
Okay. And it's good to take this little quiz, maybe 5 years, 10 years. You know, they just took it 2 years ago, and it's a little different because you start really tuning in to what you need. Okay.
So there can be a primary and a secondary.
Yes, and we'll go into that. Yeah. Okay. Way back there.
Physical touch.
Physical touch. Is that what you thought?
No.
Okay. So you need to let your wife know that. Okay. Go ahead. Okay.
Service.
Is that what you guys thought?
Mine was correct.
Okay. So, Jerry?
What I've always known.
Words of affirmation.
Words of affirmation.
Yep. Okay.
Physical touch. And that's what I told you before.
Okay. All right.
Secondary, just two secondaries.
Okay.
Words of affirmation and affirmation.
Right. And so if you're real close on some of these, it's important that the spouse knows what the three are. Okay, but we'll talk about that next week. All right?
One more, Margaret.
Well, she wasn't done. Are you done now? Okay. I was trying to give her time.
Acts of service was the highest, and then next was words of affirmation.
Okay. Very good. All right.
I had two primaries, quality time and acts of service.
Okay. All right, and Rose?
I'm kind of even.
Okay, that's fine.
the higher ones are physical touch and quality time.
Okay. All right, so this week, I want you to really pay attention to your spouse's love language. Okay. Now, I want to go back to Wendy. Wendy, what did you say yours was again? Okay, and so what do you tend to do for people?
Acts of service.
So if you get a spouse that luckily likes to receive, right, and it doesn't mean you don't need all five. When we're dating, when people date, they tend to do all five. Where the problems happen in marriage is because once you're married, many times you don't do all five, and somehow you didn't really connect with what your partner's or your spouse's love language was, and so now you start having tension and you can't figure out why. Okay, yes?
So are these things that are pretty much innate in us that we develop through childhood, or can it change over years of a relationship?
You mean a relationship with your spouse or from childhood?
Well, so did we pick up, like, if you like quality time or access service, did you pick that up as a child in your development? And then once you're an adult, and say you've been married for 20 or 30 years, Can it change over time, or is it generally kind of stay the same?
It can change some, but it basically, you're kind of born with that, and that's what I was saying, and we develop that, okay? If you're in an unhealthy household, then it may change a lot when you get older, okay? And an unhealthy childhood, let's say a child really needs physical touch, and the parent totally neglects that, okay? And that was kind of there. Then that person's going to have a little bit harder time in life trying to adjust to what theirs was, because they had to adapt. And many times you'll hear kids say, and not when they're just being competitive with their siblings, but I don't feel loved. And many times it's not that you're not doing what you need to do, but you're not meeting their love language, okay? You're tending to give what your love language is. And we can develop it in a kid. Uh-huh.
So should I give my teenager this test to find out what it is?
They actually have one for children. I think it's in the book. If it is, Wayne, I'll give it to you and you can make a copy.
I'd be curious to find out what Dominic's is.
Yeah, they actually might have it on the website. If you go to the 5, and it's the number 5, love languages, and make sure it's by Chapman, okay? I know he has the quiz that I just gave you, but I think he has one for the children as well. But Jerry's going to look in the book and see if it's in the book.
No,
there's one that's actually for children. And
that covers teens?
Yes. Yeah, look in his on his website and see, because he now has books. Yeah, he now has books out for children. I don't know if he has teenagers. He has military families, which is, you know, some differences there. Yes?
I was going to ask you, what about it? Like, if you have a tie for second and third?
We'll go to that next week. We're going to go into all the details next week. And then I'm going to give you long lists of things you can do for the different dialects, how you can meet your spouse's need, okay? And then we'll talk about some of those issues. The last week, let's see, next week is the third week, we were going to do more issues, but I'm also going to give you something that's not quite the 5 love languages. I'm going to give you a Kersey temperament sorter, which will tell you, and I'm not going to go in detail on that, I'm going to hand it to you and you will discuss a little bit, but that's whether you're an extrovert or an introvert, because that also makes a difference on how you relate to your spouse. If you're both extroverts, well, there could be competition. If one's an introvert and one's an extrovert, depending on how far apart you are, you know, that could be a problem. And people have to compromise. In other words, the introvert wants to kind of stay at home. The extrovert wants to go out all the time. So that's not a problem. You just have to learn healthy ways to deal with that. So the extrovert might be involved in meetings and community service, and the introvert will prefer to read a book, okay? But the problem would be if physical touch or quality time were also your primary love language, and now one's out there gone all the time, that could cause issues, okay? So, all right, so this week I want you to go home and see if you're actually doing those for everybody. Anybody have a question? That's actually with the quiz today. Okay, so next week we'll talk about the different primary, secondary dialects. Wayne?
Okay, quality time.
Yes.
The little sketch there that we had shows them quality time talking.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? I disagree with it.
Okay.
Because quality time with me and her is like when we're traveling or something, we may not say a word for 3 hours, but it's the ideal of her sitting there or being in that proximity.
That's the dialect. That's the dialect, okay? In other words, you were talking about hugs and kisses, okay? Then you have to go further and find out. Just sitting next to Jerry when he's over in his chair watching a movie isn't quality time for me, okay? That's for me. So you have to, not only do you have to learn their primary love language, then you learn the dialect,
okay? So since both of us like quality time,
so you go home and discuss, okay, what does that mean to us? And what does it mean to you? what does it mean to her? And you talk about it and say, okay, oh yeah, we are on the same page. And couples that have been married a long time usually are on the same page, okay? They've learned to compromise, they've learned to hear the dialect, okay? But we'll talk about...
Tell that to a teenager.
Yeah, well, teenagers are a different...
I got just a story for all.
Okay.
We were Christmas shopping this year, Dominic and I, and he wanted to buy her a cross for Christmas. And I kept telling him, no, that's not what Mimi wants. She wants this. And he kept saying, no. And I said, listen to her. Look, she's been telling us for the last couple months. So he wouldn't believe me. So we called her. And he asked, he says, Mimi, would you like to have a cross for Christmas? She goes, no. And so I told him, I said, listen to her. You didn't listen to all these little tidbits she's been laying out.
Right.
And when I told him what she was really looking for, he goes, no, it ain't. And then when we had Christmas, she opened up her gift and she goes, oh, I've been wanting this. I said, see? Listen to her.
And that is just, you're teaching him how to listen to another person's love language, and that's good.
But that's, it was funny, just, he just argued with me and,
right.
And didn't, he finally got it.
Right.
I think he finally got it.
Yeah. But I wonder if his isn't gifts or something.
I think his is gifts.
Yeah, so you might see. Yes, yeah. Wendy? Correct. Correct. And even, right, and even parents can do the same thing with their kids, not having a clue. You know, so, you know, if you do have children, it'd be, I'm not going to tell you to go do this week with them, but I want you to spend more time with your spouse right now. Okay, but if you have extra time and you want to kind of look at your children and say, oh, okay, what is their love language? If they're adult.
Stretch ourselves.
Yes. Yes, we have to. Our comfort is doing ours.
Right.
So, all right. Well, you want to end with prayer, Jerry?
Sure. This is... Thank you, Margaret.
Yeah, they said 10 till.
Great job.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Father, again, we thank you for this time to explore this area of our life, to understand better our relationships. And Lord, it'd probably be good for us to go to you in prayer and Lord, and to try and understand your love language, Lord, because you are love. Thank you for all the gifts that you give us, all the affirmation, and the other five love languages that you shower on us. We thank you for all these blessings. Be with us until we meet again. Help us to have a productive and a joyful week. And let us always rejoice in this day of celebration, this Sunday, which is yours, Lord. In all this we pray. Amen.
Amen.
In your Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. God bless you all.
All right.